Hey guys and girls, Tom Panos here, leaving my last auction for the day, and I thought I would just give you an update on what happened as I drive home. I'm about a 20 minute drive or 30 minute drive from home, and I've just finished doing an auction that was scheduled for 4 o'clock, and it is now 5:22 p.m. That is 90 minutes, or just under 90 minutes. A property in George's Hall. And I want to give you a bit of a background on how this sale actually ended up coming together after around 85 minutes. So the first thing is, the buyer doesn't show up at 4 o'clock. Let's call the buyer Habibi. I don't, for the argument's sake. Doesn't show up. So what do? We get on the phone and we ring him and he says, I'll be there in 1 minute. At 10 past four, he still was my phone, someone calling me. At 10 past four, he was still not there. And I bet you he rings me back again in a second. I'm gonna have to press the reject button again. Anyway, so I say to him, I get on the phone and I say, listen, Habibi, how long are you gonna be before you get here? He says, I'll be there in 10 minutes. I said, you said that you'd be with us 10 minutes ago. You said you'd be a minute. Anyway, bottom line is we get fucked around and we start the auction at 4:30. Long story short, it ends up becoming a wise decision because he is the best buyer. There's another two or three. Then we have the normal kerfuffle, people complaining. Why did you start the auction, right? Hey, bottom line is, no one was prepared to go anywhere where this guy's level was, and that's why, intelligently, we delayed the auction. It's always the same case, but isn't it? You have people making a big fuss, even though they pay nowhere near that figure, and say, oh, you started late. Oh, you can't register people after the auction has started. All that sort of stuff. Anyway, long story short is, property gets passed in. Property gets passed in at $825,000, and then it's a grind. And what I thought I'd do is give you some of the dialogue and language that was used to actually put this deal together. Number one, I'm saying to you, and I've said it before, walking away is part of a negotiation. So a lot of the times what you say to the buyer when they give you a number, okay, thank you so much, this one is not meant for you. All the best. See you later. Nip it in the bud straight away like that. You know why? Because if you're desperate and you're going, ha, 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 please buy it. You won't regret it. Another one sold down the road that was, you know, nowhere near as good as this, right? And it sold for 50 more. They can smell your breath that you're desperate. What do? You walk away. It's not meant for you. End of story. What does he do? He stays and doesn't leave and he's hanging around. What do you always do? Never judge people by the words they say. You judge them by their behavior. Okay? In the meantime, there's another conversation going inside with the vendors. And the vendors is this, Mr. and Mrs. Vendor. At the moment, we've got the following. We've got tightening and suffocating of money. We've got bad media. We've got a federal election that's got negative gearing on the plate. We've got nothing that's going to change the game. What are they going to do? Take rates down even lower than what they are? So there's been nothing that they can do. So I say to the owners, listen, at the moment, we've got $836,000 of your money in my hands. You want another 10. Do you think risking $836,000 to win $10,000 is a sound gamble? Do you think that that's a smart investment? At the end of the day, I don't want to give you the long convoluted version, but the deal is done and a 10% deposit is paid. But here's the learning. Whenever you get a deal done, before you say it's yours, you always say to the buyer, so let me confirm that. Your bid is $836,000. This is after the auction, I mean. Your offer is $836,000 and you're signing a contract now and you're paying a 10% deposit now. Is that correct? And the reason you do that is I can't tell you the amount of buyers who throw another spanner in the works after you've had the offer and acceptance, which is, oh, I need to go to the bank on Monday. Oh, I need to get my wife. She's at Westfield and she's doing some shopping at Coles and I need her to come in and have a look before I sign. Guys and girls, do you understand what I'm saying? The detail matters. And having clear, concise, crucial conversations with both parties is critical. The other thing I want to leave you with is this. I think that a lot of the times I use this as a tool to help vendors accept that they're not giving their property away. I'll go on to CoreLogic RP data and have a look at what the number is there, and I'll actually say, Mr. and Mrs. Vendor, I know that you want this, but can I just say, when the valuer comes in and looks at this property, the valuer will be looking at comparable sales, and CoreLogic RP data are one of the biggest sources of data across. Look at what they're saying about your property. Because it's a third party validation that then backs up on what you've been saying. So please don't underestimate about using data on the days of getting offers accepted. So ultimately, I have to say that I believe that vendors that feel that they've sold low today are gonna feel like they hit the lotto in February, March. That's the view I have. I don't have a monopoly on the truth. No one has a monopoly on the truth, but I'm making my decision based on facts and having a look at that the interest rate is so low that there is no true lever that all of a sudden is going to change things. And on that basis, guys and girls, what I'd like you to do is if you're not working tomorrow, to go home, smile at your kids, smile at your partner, put your legs up. If you enjoy having a beer, get a nice cold beer and relax. Go out to dinner, if that's what you do on a Saturday night. For those that are watching this, that are under 30, 35, I know what your life's all about, particularly if you're single, you're keeping your fingers crossed that you have a great night and you meet the person of your dreams, or that you just meet someone for the short term. I don't know what your goals are. I'm being biffed at cars by here, so I better keep moving. And adios, see you tomorrow night, Sunday Night Rant.